Whenever you're ready.
In 2014, the international community was faced with a multitude of global crises, but almost none have surpassed quite the multitude of both death and political strife as the crisis between Russia and Ukraine. An article from NPR posted just yesterday cited that the official death toll between the two opposing governments has come to over 5,000 people just in the past year. This includes just since the beginning of 2015, having at least 254 deaths so far, just between battles between the Ukrainian military and Russian separatists. And according to Reuters on December 2nd, we can look at all the actions made by Russian by separatists within Ukraine being linked directly back to Moscow, according to John Kerry, specifically stating that they've been able to intercept phone calls that absolutely guarantee the fact that most of the orders going towards Russian separatists within Ukraine are coming directly from the Russian government. Even furthermore than this, John Kerry cites that actions being taken by the United States right now, primarily being sanctions, are not working. Now, basically, this violence that's been stirred up by the Russian government, many are saying is terrorism in a sense. So when looking at whether or not the United Nations should label Russia as a state sponsor of terrorism, we need to look at a couple key things. First, we need to look at what is state-sponsored terrorism exactly. But then going into looking at what the implications would be if we didn't act in this situation, and finally, the implications if we do act in this situation in labeling the Russia a state sponsor of terrorism. So going into my first point, talking about what exactly is state-sponsored terrorism, I'm going to be going off the official definition given by the State Department most recently, which basically states that it's any government that funds, any government that provides support to violent non-state actors. This basically means any group that stirs up some sort of violence that isn't linked to the government. It further expands that many of the means used by state-sponsored terrorism include intimidation and coercion to influence policy. These are actions that have been directly taken by factions within Ukraine linked to the Russian government, including assassination attempts, kidnappings, as well as the taking over of multiple buildings, including police stations. Basically, these actions, again, according to John Kerry, can be linked directly back to Moscow and the government of Russia, and they fall directly within the parameters of what state-sponsored terrorism is, being that they've used intimidation and coercion to try to influence certain policies within Ukraine. Now, of course, the policies that they're trying to influence is more referendums within Ukraine to make certain parts of Ukraine under Russian control rather than under Ukrainian control. Now, we've seen this in Crimea and most recently also in Donetsk. And in Donetsk, they specifically used assassination attempts, bombings, as well as the use of force against civilians to try put them under control of Russian rule. So when strictly looking at what the State Department and the United Nations definition of state-sponsored terrorism is, we can see that Russia, in its support of separatists within Ukraine, falls directly under the parameters of what state-sponsored terrorism would be defined as. But next, we need to look at the implications would be if we didn't act further and label Russia a state sponsor of terrorism. First of all, we can look to an article from Reuters 10 hours ago. This states that actions being made by the United States right now are not effective. It cites that while sanctions definitely have taken a massive toll on the Russian government, Russia still has enough financial buffers to continue the exact same rate of action for at least another 2 years. This shows that while sanctions have definitely taken a toll on Russia, they're not doing enough to actually stop Russian violence. And this state sponsoring of violence within Ukraine is only going to continue for at least another 2 years unless further action is made. We can also look to an article from The Atlantic on February 1st that states when action isn't made by the West, we continue to see more and more action from Russia. Now, this was in response to the elections being held in Donetsk to basically put in place a Russian government or Russian representatives within that city to essentially put them under control of the Russian government rather than the Ukrainian government. The continued inaction has basically led to Putin citing sanctions as nothing more than just a game and basically tiptoeing around the actual issues. And we can see that his actions match his words, as even though we've put in place more and more sanctions, he continues to ramp up violence more and more to the point where he's trying to take control of more than just Crimea. This issue in Donetsk resulted in the death of another 40 civilians. So when we're looking at the fact that when he is unopposed, Putin continues to act and that the actions that we're making right now aren't working, we see that we need to take some sort of action against against Russia, and the labeling them as a state-sponsored terrorism could be just the action we need, which I'm going to explain more on my third and final point, basically citing what the implications would be if we did take the actions prescribed in this question. Specifically, we can look at various United Nations resolutions that they put in place regarding state-sponsored terrorism, specifically Resolution 1373, that states if a state is labeled as a sponsor of terrorism, certain actions have to be made by member states within the United Nations. These specifically include practical measures of military aid and defensive measures within this country, essentially being that the United States and many other member states would have to aid the Ukrainian military in some way and station some defensive measures. Now, this would send the message to Putin necessary in order to show that we truly are serious about stopping the actions that he's been making. Because according to an article from Stars and Stripes in June of 2014, Putin knows all too well that from various studies put in place that the Russian military wouldn't be able to stand the force of any intervention from any sort of United Nations or NATO troops within Ukraine. So this would send the message to Russia that we're going to do more than just financial strains on the country to stop their violence, but actual defensive measures to stop the violence that they've been putting in place against the Ukrainian people. So when analyzing the question, should the UN label Russia as a state sponsor of terrorism, the answer is going to be absolutely yes. First, looking at how they fall directly within the parameters of what state-sponsored terrorism is. Second, seeing that without taking any sort of action, violence is only going to continue within Russia. And finally, looking at if we do take action, we're going to be sending the proper message to Putin that we are willing to act in this situation and that we will not stand any further violence from Moscow.
All right.